Feminist Creativas presents A Word for Every Generation That Knows No Fashion.
Greetings. I hope and trust I find you well. We have one more experience as we linger on the mountaintop, the mountain of God at Mount Horeb. Read with me, we are still at Exodus chapter 3 and we consider verse 8. It reads as follows in the Amplified Version. And I have come down to deliver them out of the hand and power of the Egyptians, and to bring them up out of that land to a land good and large, a land flowing with milk and honey, and a land of plenty, to the place of the Canaanite, the Hittite, the Amorite, the Perizzite, the Hivite, and the Jebusite. May the good Lord bless the reading of his word as we invite his presence in prayer. Let us pray. Kind and gracious Father in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for being God our deliverer. Thank you, dear Lord, for being the God who sets us free. Thank you for paying the price and the ransom as our kinsman. Be with us now as we consider your word. Keep us safe as we go into this weekend and elevate us in experience and knowledge of thee. In Jesus' name we've prayed and we ask, amen and amen. My dear friends, just 5 points to carry you through. And at point number one, hear God speak to Moses and speak to you and I. He says, I have come down. I could not miss the immediacy that God comes down immediately. He responds to our needs. He does not waste time. He is a God who says, I will come down. I do not only see things. I do not hear things. I do not just know things, but I take corrective action. I come down and I take care of business. Go back and you're going to find in the first chapter of John, the word was with God and the word became flesh. That is, came down and dwelt among men. Even though they did not know him, he had come down. This is the God who always comes down and the God we're about to worship over the weekend. Fast forward to chapter 10. He says, the thief cometh not, but to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But listen to this. I have come down so that they might have life and they might have it more abundantly. You and I are guaranteed life because God is a God who comes down to his creation. God is a God who always takes action. At point number two, not only has he come down, he has a mission. And what is his mission? To deliver them. We are a captured people. We are an imprisoned people. We are an enslaved people. We are an incarcerated people. We have been oppressed by sin for far too long. And God has come on a mission to deliver you and I. God is on a mission to deliver this earth. And he says, my child, you shall not be in bondage for long. Sin shall not have a hold over you for a long time. I am here to deliver you. What do you need deliverance from? Is it an issue that has to do with your morality? I will set you free. I will deliver you. Is it an issue that is a spiritual matter? You are afflicted by Satan and the forces of evil. I will deliver you. I will deliver you from the hand and the power of evil. God can set us free. God can set us free. This I do not doubt. This I believe. God is here. And the time is now for us to be delivered and set free. Claim the promise this morning. For whosoever the Son of Man sets free, he is free indeed. You are free in the name of Jesus. He sets us free. Point number three. He says, not only have I come down, not only will I deliver them. When I have delivered them, these are the two things I'll do. I will bring them up and out of that land. God will not leave us the same. An encounter with Jesus lifts us up. Many of us have gone seeking greener pastures, and in the process, we have wandered away from Jesus Christ. And this just leaves us at a down low, at the lowest point in the abyss of sin, in the valley of sin, in the darkness of sin. And Christ says, when I have come up, come down, I mean, I will bring them up. Just like that ship which was lost of the 100, the one that strayed, he took it and put it on his shoulders and brought it up from where it was lost. May Christ bring us up. May Christ elevate us this weekend. May Christ even take us out from where we are lost. Because we, many a time, want to be saved and remain in the same position. When will you move out? When Christ has called you, he will take you out of fornication. He will take you out of adultery. He will take you out of thievery. He will take you out of witchcraft. He will take you out of disobedience to your law, to your parents. He will take you out of embezzlement of funds and corruption. He will take you out of violating his 10 commandments. That is the God we serve. He is a God who takes us out. He is a God who does not leave us where we are. He is a God who wants to make us better than what we were before. Remember, when he dealt with Abraham, he says, I have met you in Ur of the Chaldeans, but I will take you out. Where will I take you out to? I'm taking you to a promised land, a land that you have never seen, a land that you have never known. Talk to Joseph. He has many dreams and he says, now I'm about to bless you. I will take you out from the land where you live. I will take you to Egypt. When you get there, you are going to be elevated. You are going to be out of your misery. I will turn you into from a shepherd boy into a prime minister. God takes us up and out. Let him take you up. Let him take you out. That is our Lord. That is our God. He will take us up and take us out. And point number four. Let's not belabor the point. Notice this. Notice this. They were the Canaanites. Who were the Canaanites? These are the descendants of Noah. I mean the ones that came out of the ark. They are the descendants. With the same background, they are basically the cousins of the Israelites. Who are the Israelites? They're the ones who have moved now from Israel to go to Egypt. While they're in Egypt, they turn into economic refugees. We spoke about them on Monday. Now, as they find themselves in this situation, now God says, I will take you out of the hand and power of the Egyptians. Why will I take you out? So that I can give you the land of your cousins, the Canaanites. Some of us, at point number four, because we are reluctant to learn from the blessings of God, what he has given unto us, what he has entrusted upon us, because we are reluctant to do so, guess what? God gives us an alternative lesson that we are not going to miss, a lesson of withdrawal. When we do not appreciate what God has put in our hands, God decides that this I will take away. I will withdraw so that you can appreciate that I am the giver and appreciate that I am the sustainer. Appreciate that I am the one who establishes you. Appreciate that I am the great I am. When we refuse and we go after idols that we have carved out for ourselves, God will talk to us through the blessings of withdrawal. Some prayers that are yet to be answered, we hold the answers to those prayers when God withdraws what we have in our hands and gives it to his children who believe and call upon his name. At point number five, as we climax and wrap it up, as you take off, may I give you this assurance, God is about to deliver you. Your deliverance has started loading. It is in progress. I believe it, and please do believe it. God has started the work of setting you free from whatever is holding you at ransom. God has paid the price. You are free, but take note. God is holding this conversation with Moses, and he says, Moses, I will send you to deliver the children of Israel. But as Moses takes this baton stick, he runs on a sprint only to go as far as Mount Pisgah, the hills of Moab, where he is laid to rest. And in the book of Jude, he is exhumed and Christ takes him to heaven. And we meet him thereafter at the Mount of Transfiguration. But Moses did not run the whole race. As Moses has run his whole race, God changes his tactic and he says, now I will attack from the midfield, and he uses Joshua. Joshua is distributing as he goes now with Kenan on the left, Joshua on the right. They are marshalling the children of Israel right into the promised land, and they cross the river Jordan to go right into Canaanite land, and they start to clear them out. The Canaanites, they are gone. The Hittites, they are gone. The Amorites are no more. The Perizzites are dealt with. The Hivites are annihilated. And finally, there remains the Jebusites. These were not taken out because Joshua did not manage to supplant them. God says, now I'm going to have my striker who just finished the deal, who just closed the transaction, and his name is the little boy who played on a harp. His name is David, the son of Jesse. He shall come in and deal with the Jebusites, and when he is done, all that shall remain in the place is my city of peace, Jerusalem. God is going to build a place of peace in your life, and this is a guarantee, this is a promise, this is a warranty. You can claim it, it is bankable. God says, I will deliver you. It might take time, it might not take time as you expect, but my time, when it is complete, you shall be set free, and you shall be free indeed. I am on a delivery mission, and I will deliver you even out of earth. And when the time is come, we shall enter the gates with praise into the city of Jerusalem. For we are marching to the new Jerusalem, the city of peace. Blessings and peace. May God keep you until we meet again on Monday morning. Until then, stay safe and God bless.